do these people know PlayStation, and what kind of strategy do they, you know, bring to the game to make themselves the best tester possible? Hey, I'm Greg Miller from IGN.com. I'm the PlayStation Executive Editor. IGN.com is the name in video game news, reviews, previews, features, insight. Basically, we are the number one experts, and we're very, very lucky and blessed to have a fan base that follows us around the world. My role on Tester Season 3 right now is that I'm the judge coming in to basically decide if these guys know their metal when it comes to PlayStation 3 and the industry in general. They have a big opportunity on their hands joining Santa Monica, and I'm here to make sure they actually know things about PlayStation and see if they have the strategy to come ahead in this industry. It's a huge deal that the winner of Tester Season 3 gets to go work at Santa Monica Studio. Once you're inside the industry, it's a very close-knit community. People leave companies and go to different sites or go to different developers all the time, but they all know each other. It all comes back and forth, you know what I mean? You make relationships here that even when a project's done and you move on to something else, you're gonna know somebody that a year later you're gonna end up working with again. And that's why it's so crucial that Tester Season 3 is giving these people a chance to get in. It seems that Tester always weeds it down to genuinely good people that you want to see succeed. And that even if they don't win the tester, I still see Amped everywhere. Every event I go to, Amped is there. Nauseous too. I see, you know, I mean, you see these people doing things in the industry because once you have that passion and someone ignites it and gives you that chance, there's nowhere, I mean, you can do anything you want with it.